So a week ago, the Wildcats won the WBL meet, just not the Wildcats that everyone was expecting, as Kenton took home the tournament title, while Bath, the regular season champs, won the overall crown thanks to their better record in dual meets. Both sets of Wildcats, along with several other local teams, in action today at Country Acres for the Division II sectional. And they got a beautiful morning to do it at, looking for the top three teams and top four individuals to advance on to districts. Bath's Evan Hall had a monstrous drive on this short par four, drains the par putt, 78 for Hall on the day. Liberty Benton's Adam August with a par attempt as well, no problems. He finished with 77. But Jared Hernandez of Van Wert, he's putting for birdie here, plays it out to the left to play the break, and it's hooking back. It stops just left of the hole, great putt. And a tap in par 81 for Jared. How about Eric Paris of OG, finishing out his hole with a downhill tester, finds the bottom of the cup, 87 today for Paris. Par 4 first now, Coldwater's Tyler Canty chipping on the third, his third shot almost falls, it hits the stick. He would tap in for par 78 for Canty. How about Jimmy Ebling of Elida for par? Good roll and a good 4 for Ebling. 93 for the Elida Bulldog. How about Kenton's Britton? Hensel also putting for par, and it falls. Nicely done by the medalist of last week's WBL meet. 76 for Hensel today. And still on the first, Carter Bowman of St. Mary's. He's going to putt for par here. Tricky little putt. Has the speed right, but it's a little left. Doesn't matter. He would hole out from there for bogey, and he finished with the low round of the day, 72. The teams moving on are Liberty Benton. They come in first, 313. Bath and Kenton also advancing to districts. St. Mary's and Napoleon just missing out. The individuals, Carter Bowman, 72. Tyler Canty of Coldwater, 78. St. Mary's, Colin Burke, 79. Bryan's, Jared Miller, 79. All going to districts.